Hi, everybody. Welcome back to In Focus. Today is Profile Day here in Focus, and joining us on the show are In Focus Profiles, Shayna Fox, Guy Handelman, and Mike Lalaian. Mike Lalaian. There we go. I've got to get that right. And they're students at Grant High School. And also joining us, the students right here, is Alex Hakobian. He is the film and video instructor at Grant High School's film and video department. Welcome to the show, everybody.
Welcome to the show.
And good to have you guys on. You know, we've talked about you a little bit on the Vic Awards, and it's such great work that you do, and that's why we're profiling you here today. And Mr. Hakobian, you teach over there. It's a magnet school for film and video department. Tell us about that.
Right. We're a communications technology magnet. We have a number of different parts. We have a computer section. We have a newscasting section. And then we have the film and video department.
Why is it part of a magnet? Explain that real quick.
Well, magnet is a federally funded integration program. That's how it was set up. And they specialize in certain subjects. There's a zoo magnet that specializes in zoology.
And
animal behavior and animal, taking care of animals. And there's math magnets and there are science magnets and so on. So we happen to
specialize in film and video. Now, if somebody wants to transfer in, do they have to do that to really get to the heart and core of film and video?
There are a number of schools around LAUSD that have summer magnets and summer not magnets, and they have film and video programs.
Okay. Mm-hmm,
If you have to apply for the magnet, and they have a way of determining points and who gets in and when they get in and so on.
Okay, so now we're going to talk to you guys. You've produced two films, Growing Older and 10 Minute Run. Mm-hmm. Tell us about these films.
Okay, I produced On Growing Older, mm-hmm. and I co-produced 10 Minute Run with Guy Handelman. I'll tell you about On Growing Older and he can tell you about 10 Minute Run.
Boy, how professional are you right away? Listen to you. You should be running the show right now. And now we can see where they come from, Alex. Go right ahead.
Sure. On Growing Older is about this elderly woman, and she tells the retrospective story of her life to an arrogant young nurse. And I strive to make old age palpable to an ageless audience. And people reacted like, you know, young kids were crying and were able to identify with what this old woman was going through. And older people were able to kind of remember their past.
Where did you get the idea?
Actually, my mom showed me this. It's a poetry video. And my mom showed me this poem, and I based the video on the poem.
Based it on the poem?
On the poem.
Yeah. And that you got everybody to work with you, your students, that is, and how long did it take you?
It took me about, maybe 5 months to shoot, and a lot of editing hours. Editing is a long process, but I love editing because you can see all your work come together. It's like putting the pieces of the puzzle together.
Where did you get your actresses, the nurse and the grandmother?
The woman that played the nurse, Darlene Carden, she does professional acting. She's a family friend. And same with the woman that did the nurse, so I was privileged to have her.
Because I saw a piece of it before we started the show, and it looked very, very interesting, but at the same time, very, very sad. Okay, what about the 10-minute run?
The 10-minute run's a cute little film. We tried to aim it for, especially for children, but it could be viewed by anybody, really. Mm-hmm. It's about a boy, played by me, who runs the 10-minute run. 10-minute run in our school, you have to run around a track for 10 minutes nonstop. It's pretty brutal. Yeah, but we kind of
How many takes? How many times did you have to do the 10-minute run?
Many, many times. But anyway, at first the boy doesn't want to really run. He's kind of a chicken or whatever. But then as he starts to run, he starts to gain confidence in himself and starts to realize it's not so bad, and he gets an A in his class in the end.
Interesting subject that you choose right there, because that's a lot mirrors life. Because a lot of times as you're growing up, you fear certain things until you actually get to do them and you gain the self-confidence.
Yeah, that was the message we were going for. Mr. Hakobian has always taught us that messages and themes in our videos were probably the most important part of filmmaking. if you don't have something to say, then there's no use in using, no point in saying anything at all.
Well, let's say it right now, because we're going to take a look at growing older right now and see what they're all about.
Old woman, not very wise, uncertain of habit and far away eyes, who dribbles her food and makes no reply, and forever is losing a stocking or shoe, who, unresisting or not, lets you do as you will. Is that what you're thinking? Is that what you see? Open your eyes, nurse, as I sit here so still, as I do your bidding, as I eat at your will. I'm a small child of 10 with father and mother, brothers and sisters who love and play fairy tale games. A young girl of 16 with wings on her feet, dreaming that soon now a lover shall meet. Will he make me nervous with butterflies galore? Will our souls dance together until they become one? I hope he can love me unconditionally. Oh, sweet boy. Of you I dream. A bride soon at 20, my heart gives a leap, remembering the vow that I promised to keep. At 25, as my outward appearance evolves along with my inward soul, I have young children of my own who need me to build a secure, happy home. My young now grow fast, bound to each other with ties that should last. At 40, my young sons have grown and are gone. My man's beside me to see, I don't mourn. Too soon for words, I'm a grandmother of 4. Again, we know children, my loved one and me. Dark days are upon me. My husband is dead. I look at the future and I shudder with dread. I'm an old woman now, and nature is cruel. 'Tis her jest to make old age look like a fool. The body, it crumbles. Grace and vigor depart. Never have I felt so weak. Oh, my heart. But inside this old carcass, a young girl still dwells. And now and again, my battered heart swells. I remember the joys. I remember the pain. And I'm loving and living life over again. I think of the years all too few, gone too fast. And accept the stark fact that nothing can last. So open your eyes, nurse. Open and see. Not a crabby old woman, look closer. See me.
Wow, pretty heady stuff right there.
Yes.
Shayna Fox got a great name for film and television, that's for sure. Good job on that. And that was also your parents you had in there as well.
Yes.
Well, we got to take a short break right now, but we are going to continue our conversation with our In Focus profiles. We're going to get to that other 10-minute run film right after this. We'll be right back.
Can't do it all. Do what you can. Compassion for others. Pass it on. A message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
Hung up about a consumer problem? Like that refrigerator you just bought that's freezing you out. Oh, and telemarketers who won't stop calling.
Have I got a deal for you?
Well, stand up for your rights. Use the power of the internet and the federal government at pueblo.gsa.gov, the free consumer action website. Thousands of links to companies and government agencies with names, numbers, and advice to get your wrongs righted. Remember Pueblo, because you never know.
Welcome back to In Focus. Now, if you're just tuning in, today is Profile Day, Monday here on In Focus. And we're profiling the students from Grant High School who wrote, produced, and directed, and edited their own films. And you just saw one of them right there. And that was Growing Older, which is really a pretty heavy, serious topic. And Shayna, how'd you get into that?
Well, like I said, I based it on a poem titled On Growing Older by Phyllis McCormack. And one of the things Mr. Hakobian has stressed is to have a message when you create a video, to say something to your audience. And I think that the beauty of film is that, you know, you can help someone to think, to reflect, to walk out of that theater a changed person. And I think that
how old are you?
17,
you're well on your way.
I want to know.
That talk right there. She's ready to go.
It's amazing. When you read this poem, you have to have a certain sensibility, because I wouldn't think too many kids would read it and would automatically think, what can I convey? What can I put out there so everybody can see it? So what was the process of you reading the poem and saying, I can put this on film and I can let many people see what is actually written on this?
When I read the poem, when I was finished, I had tears in my eyes, and it touched me and it made me think. And I kind of gained this appreciation for life, and I thought, you know, I shouldn't take things for granted. And it's just such a beautiful message, and I wanted to share that with other people.
Have you had any loss in life early?
Actually, my grandmother passed away right before I produced the film, and I think that
helped.
Yeah, inspired.
Interesting.
That's an inspiration for you.
Yeah.
That's wonderful.
Mike, you got something else you're going on right now, don't you? You're starting a new project for yourself. What is that?
Yeah, and it starts Shayna in it. So it's my video, like we said, Mr. Hakobian stresses that we have to have a message and purpose for our videos. Now, my particular video is named Salvation, and the whole theme is salvaging. And it takes place, this is kind of strange, but it takes place in the year 2065, you know, and we have a lot of budget in this, a lot of work went into it. And mostly what it's about is the world, because of pollution, overpopulation, wars, things like that, the world has more or less crumbled. And this is about two people finding each other and basically trying to start a new world, you know, rebuilding and salvaging what they can. And, you know, we're spending like night hours using all this equipment that we haven't really used before, and really trying to stress the theme of this is really is a destroyed world. And Shayna's, like I said, she's leading.
So you're in pre-production right now.
We're in production.
You're in production right now.
Yeah.
Got any budget difficulties with the studio? That anything?
Yeah. Yeah. The execs are getting
script issues.
Kind of,
things.
Yeah. The execs are a little on our tails.
We have a $14 budget on that.
Yeah.
$14 budget.
That's
Hollywood.
A good one.
But it's amazing you can get it done on a $14. That's really a shoestring budget.
Mm-hmm.
But Alex, you know what? You're talking about a process that you do.
Right.
You take the kids in ninth grade or so, and then they go up through the whole program. Tell us how that works.
Right. We have three levels. We have beginning, intermediate, and advanced students. And it's a full program. Two intermediate classes, two beginning classes, one advanced class. They come to me in the ninth grade, and I give them the basics, the technical part of filmmaking, and then we go on into story development, and we go through the whole process, just like you would if you were a professional, except on a much smaller scale.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like to use the word messages, that we send messages. Early on, and
it's a story that needs to be told.
Yeah, more like that.
Yeah,
or make people think.
Messages sounds like you're a preacher, you know. But yeah. I like to think of it as if we're going to waste our time or spend our time making a movie, we have to be ethical. We have to do something that will help somebody or teach somebody something or try to make things better. That doesn't mean everything is nicey nice all the time. Mike's story is far from that. It's a mm-hmm. destroyed world, but. What can we come out of a movie theater feeling some kind of hope, some kind of a possibility of success? And we do a lot of shows during the year that never make it to the top echelon, and mm-hmm. I try to eliminate all the shows where people want to do karate. All the kids want to
but
do
karate.
But
you're giving kids the opportunity throughout the whole year
yeah.
so that they're in the program and
right.
they're always gaining something no matter what process or what part of the program they're in.
Right.
Like Guy, you have your 10-minute run, which we were talking about earlier in the
yeah.
first segment. Let's go ahead and take a look at that right now if we can.
Okay.
Oh no, another 10-minute run. I'm such a wimp. I can't even do one half a lap, let alone a full one.
Glad to see that everybody made it here bright and early this morning. Let's take roll and get ready to go here with our 10-minute run.
I'm in last place. Up the better. I hope that girl isn't looking at me.
What could possibly be worse?
To thank you for saving me back there.
Oh, you're welcome.
All right, let's go.
Okay. You know, you did really great today. Good job. I think it's the best you've ever done.
I know. I can't believe how fast I could run.
Yeah. It's amazing what you can do when you believe in yourself.
Guy, you look like you were going to the dogs there for a minute, but you wound up okay at the end.
Yeah.
That,
believe it or not, that scene took like 5 hours to shoot just for that, like,
the one where you're
seconds.
Falling?
No, the dog.
The dog,
thing.
Because sometimes yeah. the dogs don't want to do
it. They have a mind of their own, don't they?
Yeah.
I had a piece of steak in my pocket, and the dog had to run after us.
Oh, that's a very good incentive for
yeah,
that.
Yeah, there you go.
You're also submitting your work to a couple of film festivals. Tell us about that.
Well, we submitted to the Vic Awards. We won a few Vic Awards last
mm-hmm.
year.
Few. Many.
And then we just sent it to the Cine Eagles, the Cine Golden Eagles. Where's that? Where?
Washington, D.C.
Washington, D.C.
That's in D.C., and that's a national type of thing.
Yeah, that's a national thing.
International.
you know, we compete with, you know, NYU and stuff, so it's yeah. it's a pretty
so
big award.
That's great competition for you. You're doing a great job. I'm sorry, I've got to wrap it up here real quick.
All right.
Great job, 10-minute run, growing older.
You.
Yours coming out here real soon, Mike and Alex, always. Good job over there at Grant High School. And if you'd like for more information about Grant High School's film and video department, which is a part of their communications and technology magnet, please call 818-781-1400 over there at Grant High School. And thank you guys for joining us here today and in Focus. Please tune in tomorrow for Health Day. Bye-bye, everybody.
If you would like to order a videotape of this or any episode of In Focus, please send a check or money order for $20 to KLCS-TV, Attention Sales, P.O. Box 4349, Los Angeles, California, 90051. Please indicate the date the show aired. Thank you for watching KLCS.